Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. By the word of the Lord, the heavens were made. These are the words we heard sung in the Alleluia verse. They don't quite sound the same just recited. There's something about the music that accompanies them which allows us to peer into the mystery of creation. So many imaginations and reflecting on creation often perceive it as coming forth from a song. In the Jewish Midrash, which is a commentary on the Hebrew Scriptures, there's a story told about creation, about which Hebrew letter God would select to be the very first one in the Torah, opening the book of Genesis. The story unfolds in God's divine court, and all of the Hebrew letters are gathered together there. And of course, everyone's expecting that Aleph, who stands first in the series, is going to be the one that gets to open Genesis. God looks around. There's somebody missing. I only see 21 of the 22 letters. Lo and behold, behind one of the pillars, hiding, is the humble Bet. God calls her forth. And so, Revelation, the beginning, Bereshit, begins with the second letter of the Hebrew alphabet. And there's an overwhelming amount of speculation as to why that is. Simply, it's because creation is not a closed reality. Creation is like a finger pointing to the Creator. Creation begins not with Aleph, but with Beth, because it's looking at the wonderful artwork which the universe is. We see something that points beyond itself. You see in creation, in the universe, a message, which implies a messenger. You see a work of art, which implies an artist, a work of art sent by a lover. We know that love always includes two movements. There's the pouring out of a lover towards the beloved, and there's a corresponding desire to be loved in return. And just as all the visible expression of God's love is begun with the humble Bet, so it was left to the Aleph later in the Torah to describe what our response to the Creator looks like. It's Aleph, the first letter of the Hebrew alphabet, which begins the commandments. Those 10 commandments which conclude with what we heard in the passage from Deuteronomy, the Shema Israel, the most important prayer in Jewish practice. You shall love the Lord your God with all your being. The response that we are to have to our Lord. Our union with God is affected by becoming like Him, a lover. A lover with all the creativity of an artist to express that love in as many and as passionate ways as possible. It's an unfortunate fact that we tend to reduce reality to what is practical, to what is seen, to what seems to pertain to my situation in the here and now. And we forget how mysterious and how wonderful reality is. In the same way, we tend to reduce God to a set of rules, forgetting that He's a person, and we grow so tired in our relationship with Him. On the cross, the Father gave His word to us. The word by whom all things were made became man and dwelt among us to break through those hearts hardened. He came to pour out love to the point where He had nothing. to remind us of the tremendous thirst God has for our love in return. On the cross, we hear the plaintive cry, "I thirst." And so let us respond generously to this tremendous lover.